Hi, I'm Mike Good with the STS-125 Hubble crew, and you're watching NASA TV.
Good morning to you today, Mike Good.
Good morning, Houston, and thanks for lifting us up even higher with that song this morning. We're looking forward to going outside and working on Hubble. Hopefully that'll bring glory to the Lord of all creation. And special hello to Tony, Brian, Jason, and Shannon, who I'm sure will be watching along with me today.
And thanks a lot. We agree.
And so the crew of Atlantis begins flight day five. Today's Wicked Music was God of Wonders, and it was played for Mission Specialist Mike Good, who along with Mission Specialist Mike Massimino will complete the mission's second spacewalk today, giving the Hubble Space Telescope brand new batteries and three brand new rate sensing units. As the crew starts preparations for that spacewalk by Massimino and Good, Commander Scott Altman and Mission Specialist Megan MacArthur will conduct the inspection of the front left portion of Atlantis's thermal protection system, an area right under the front part of the nose. There's about 40 tiles that mission managers here in Houston want them to get better imagery of. Once those images are captured, they'll be downlinked to the teams here in Houston for analysis to make sure that Atlantis's heat shield remains in good shape and ready for re-entry.
Beautiful view now looking back over the tail of Atlantis, the Nile River clearly in view, the Sinai Peninsula, the Mediterranean off to the right with Cyprus in view there to the right lower portion of the Mediterranean in this view. Mike Massimino, first out of the airlock. He is beginning his third spacewalk and third to service the Hubble Space Telescope. He will be the free-floating astronaut throughout today's EVA. Throughout the spacewalks, the transparent number 19 down in the lower right corner will signify the view from Mike Massimino's helmet camera. And number 20 will signal that that's the helmet cam view from Michael Good's helmet.
Detroit.
Colonel Good, welcome to the wonderful world of working in a vacuum. I heard RSU with your name on it waiting for you.
Okay, I'm going to hop up in the arm. All right.
And Mike Good now in the foot restraint, Megan MacArthur in control of the robotic arm. She'll be taking him back to a protective enclosure, the small ORU, Orbital Replacement Unit protective enclosure, referenced by the acronym SOAP. He will be in charge of retrieving the new rate sensor units and handing those off to Mike Massimino, who will be mounted on a foot restraint inside the telescope.
How you doing, Mike? Good, I'm coming down right over your head. All right, I see you. Look good. Megan, you've got about 2 feet from the boot plate to the nope.
Copy that.
And stop motion.
Motion is stopped.
John, I've got a tether on the RSU.
Excellent.
Serial number 1004.
Thank you.
Transform module's coming open.
The view from Mike Massimino's helmet cam, watching Mike Good remove the first of the brand new rate sensor units. These 24-pound units are sized 13 inches long by 10 inches wide by 9 inches high. He will be working off the end of the robotic arm, transporting the new units up to the telescope to assist Mike Massimino, who will be conducting the removal of the old units that are inside Hubble.
And the handrails look as you described yesterday, John.
Thanks, man. And just a reminder to the both of you, watch out for the lube on the bolts.
Okay.
Mike Massimino's reflection in the aft shroud of the Hubble Space Telescope as he prepares to open the doors, protective doors over the fixed head star trackers and the rate sensor units.
John, it's 10:30, right down, hip pins in.
Good work.
Look,
okay,
look,
so the next will be the mass insertion position.
Sounds good. Trained my whole life for this. Okay, Miles, just watch the RSU. I'm going to back away, okay?
Yeah, get out of the way. I'm gonna stay right here.
Megan, now, away 2 feet.
Coming away.
How's that look, Mike?
It looks perfect, Mike. Great job.
Okay, Mike, I show clear in front of me.
Okay, I'm coming.
Come on across.
Okay, Mike, I'm going to wait right here for you.
Okay, you can start heading up if you want. Megan, I'm ready to come on in.
Copy.
Mike, I'm not going to go any further until you're able to stabilize me, okay?
Okay. And Megan, I think we need to come a little to my left and into the telescope.
Copy, about 6 inches left.
Sounds great.
Copy.
And John, it looks pretty cool in here. And those neon lines might be interesting. They look like they may be sticking out just a little bit, but I think there'll be no problem.
Okay,
again, that's
camera?
The same material as the black?
Yep, the black, yeah, so that's the neon line, right? That's coming up in there with the funny-looking connector.
Yep.